challenge that you're meeting, so. Well, I'm anxious to see what things look like, so.
You'll be impressed.
Sign from the high school, actually.
Right here?
One of the things that we had.
They said there was nothing left.
One of the things we had at the old school was just one common meeting area. And once we called it allowed. But now we have several areas in the school where students can get together. And it was very overcrowded. We had 2,200 students in a school with probably around 1,800 students, more functional, easier to function. This area here, there are a lot of areas in the school like this. And this area is meant to be used to teach. All the hallways are meant for us to be used, where principals like to walk down the hallways and get kids around the class. When we get this up and running like we want to see kids everywhere. You know, working around with the teachers, because they all have computers now, all the students have laptops. And so these areas are all info lanes. Everything that the teachers are developing now is going to be online resources, whether it be online text messages, or resources that they've researched on the internet, and they're putting those resources together to fit our curriculum to meet the system.
And with the UAE matching grant, everybody has a computer?
Yes, all the students have.
9 through 12?
Nine through 12. Students in both buildings do. So even though the spaces over at Memorial aren't flexible like this, and what you're going to see, we have remixed the teachers so that they're not in their discipline. They're across the hall from math and science.
Right.
So we're really trying to work with that concept for our new high school, even there as well as here. We just have the nice flexible spaces.
Yeah. See, what, are you not using traditional textbooks? If I was in here on a regular school day, I wouldn't see people carrying around four books in a backpack.
If they're in a College Board Advanced Placement course or a dual credit course, they're one of Missouri universities that we offer, which we offer about 12 AP and 12 dual credit, you can see them in the textbook. But we're also trying to acquire resources from some of those folks too, to get the use from the online aspect, because there's a lot of online courses, like for instance, Missouri Southern next door to us does a lot with online, just like every course. So we partner with them on several courses. All the big classrooms have this type of arrangement too, so teachers can supervise kids out in the hall, kids in the meeting room, kids here. You can have all kinds of big things. And the way their classrooms are positioned, like I said, they're disciplinary. You can have a social studies teacher and a communication arts teacher working together on large projects and just have a significant number of kids doing that. I learned from the architects more than anything, and we've looked at a couple designs in 21st century high schools, is utilizing the whole space. You know, like I said, we had narrow hallways, so they made the classroom bigger. So in this case, we have bigger classrooms, we made a little bit bigger hallways, think about using the hallway. Mm-hmm. And that's what we're trying out before we get into a new school.
Well, yeah, this will give you a way to test a lot of theories before you permanently locate for a generation.
Exactly, and we have to test them quickly. The architects came to us with this idea, and there's probably a few schools in the country that have this, but I think mostly more from a corporate aspect. Uh-huh. But movable walls so that you could create larger learning spaces. So the idea of having a social studies teacher and a communication arts teacher, which is what we have here back to back, means that they can work across disciplines easier. You don't have the limitations of a boxed classroom anymore, and you can have things going on.
So I had the news on in a different room this morning, and Charlie said I needed to turn it off because it was distracting him from his Lego project. So I'm wondering if somebody's talking over here, if that distracts you from...
I mean, we definitely
Charlie
have
clearly
some
would be distracted. Really,
we definitely have some really loud teachers. I mean, we have Coach Linden, who just his voice is just yell.
Just loud.
And I mean, there's teachers that are joking like they're gonna be throwing ping pong balls over if you get too loud. Or, I mean, it's just stuff like that. But
it's not as bad as what you would think. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you look at you, man, it's gonna be really loud.
Well, the walls are pretty high.
Yeah, it's not.
The carpet's
here.
The carpet absorbs.
I think that the big problem we had in the old high school, again, going back to what Gary said, our hallways were so small, it's like miserable. Yeah. So we have to go and get to the next class. Traditional high school school that was already too small anyway. It was built for about 1,600 students and 2,200 in it.
Right.
So we had overcrowding issues already.
Right.
So I think an open layout nice.
Yeah, they've already got a cross project across this one already with the marketing of the costumes. They're going to sell mugs.
Yeah, I like the look of it. I like the way they, you know, drop the raceway in, visible, but they're doing what it's supposed to do, keeping all that stuff out of the way.
I went to the University of Maryland.
So what are you doing with the library?
Well, let's go ahead and take a look. And we'll have the hardbacks in here as well. But
well, you know, as a former teacher, it makes it harder when all the kids actually know how to access the real answers. that's a huge disadvantage when the kids have, when the students
not
have.
For us.
Yeah, that's right. Hell no, it says right here. We just Googled whatever it was you said, Mr. Blunt.
Well, and that's a real big deal for teachers to really rethink how they're teaching.
Right.
To guide learning and get and know where those answers are. To guide them to an end product and to push the students. And that's a transition we're going through right now. The teachers are doing a good job. We've got a lot of professional development support.
A lot less space than you would have had in the high school library before, right?
Which, you know,
but
makes you
a lot more information.
Sure. I mean, they've got, every kid's got the laptop, and they've got, I mean, the whole world really at their disposal. And
the idea of your textbooks and your research material and everything being in that laptop you're carrying around, and obviously that's what we've been talking about for a long time. Mm-hmm. But to be, you know, to make the transition by necessity is it puts you in an interesting place that other schools aren't in because they haven't had to be there. You know, they, well, we know we need to do that, and we'll eventually get it done. And
but there's no lockers in here, and that was something that the students were engaged in that conversation early on as we were doing the design phase. And do you guys want lockers? And the answer, oh, we don't. If we got a laptop and a backpack, we're good to go, and that's worked well.
Like your school, Charlie?
No.
Not really, does it?
Sure.